Hey y'all, this is Eliana with Why Not reDesign, and today I will show you how I transformed this buffet into the orange buffet of my dreams. I first started by spraying on brown spray can paint. Yes, I know it sounds crazy, but I have something in mind. I want this buffet to be an old world looking buffet, and I needed it to have some crackling effect, and that's exactly what brown paint does. I also chose Dixie Belle paints and products to do this buffet with, and I'm going to use several different colors, many brushes, and several techniques to achieve the look that I want. Like I said, I began by spraying on brown paint on it, and I started mixing the paint, the different paint colors from Dixie Belle that I chose, with what is called sea spray, which is like a textured powder. Once you mix it with the paint and start applying it, you can apply it in different places of the piece that you're using, and what it will do is it will create like a raised effect on the piece that you can then sand back and apply different colors on top of it, and then when you sand it back, then you can see the original color that you applied the sea spray with. I will show you more as the video goes by. Right here you see me, I have applied different colors with sea spray, and I'm now starting to apply the orange paint. This took a couple of different coats. I think I ended up doing 3 coats of the orange paint so that I achieved the color that I wanted, or the coverage that I wanted. As you can see right there, the sea spray on the top gave it a lot of texture, and I applied a different color. I applied the color sand on that. And here I am applying different colors with, combining different colors with the orange to start getting like an old world effect that I wanted. I also ended up using 3 different colors of orange, and I will list everything on the description so that you guys can see. There was a lot of painting. This process took a couple of days, and at the end, I ended with exactly what I wanted. I kept this buffet in my house, so I wasn't afraid of using the orange. I know that it's not gonna be for everyone, but I am a true believer of having a piece of furniture in your house that doesn't match with anything that you own. And this time around, I wanted it to be orange. Most of my other pieces are either white or green. So, orange it is, at least for now. Right here you can see how the texture looks, and I have applied coffee bean and also chocolate on top. Those are other colors by Dixie Belle, and there is a combination of all of those colors and the texture of the sea spray, and it ended up being a little bit too much for my liking. So I did, you will see soon, that I ended up actually sanding down some of that sea spray so that it was a little bit smoother. Here I am doing yet another coat of the orange, and then applying more chocolate and different layers on the top, because the top I wanted it to be an old world look, but I wanted to be different from the body of the buffet. Right here you can see I'm doing some dry brushing, and you see that texture, how cool it looks. There I am actually starting to chip back some of that texture, because as you can see, it was quite raised, and to the left of or under my arm, you'll see that I actually took too much in some spaces. Which is okay, because since this is a layered effect, I just went back and applied more paint, and that just gave texture to the buffet everywhere. I use my surf prep sanding system to take back some of that texture as well. And here I am reapplying paint in the spots where all of the paint came off. So basically I just started it from zero, from scratch again, but it looked really good. I used terracotta, and I used flamingo, and I used a Florida orange on these colors, and mixed them in layers so that you could see different, just like all the colors, but in different ways. And I love the effect of it. Part of the legs, I did the same as the top, so that there was a little bit of a difference in the design of the buffet, because it's a beautiful buffet. Like I said, this process took several days. So I went back and forth. Here I am applying waxes to seal the paint, and I'm applying, Dixie Belle has a liquid wax, which is fantastic to work with, super easy. And I am also applying brown, black, and clear waxes to create different depths within the details of the buffet. On the inside of the doors and the drawers, I ended up doing a combination of the green colors. Some green colors, I used evergreen, I used a couple other ones. I will list them all. I don't have the information in front of me, and the colors are skipping my mind right now, the color names. But I also used this tropical transfer that you see, also by Dixie Belle, and I just wanted to give it a little bit of interest. I like to see pretty everywhere when I open the drawers and inside of them. The drawers were in fantastic shape. So what I did inside of them is I applied Big Mama's butter, and that not only conditioned the wood, but made it smell very good. I did that also inside the cabinet behind the doors. The transfers are super easy to apply. I also used a gold gilding wax, again by Dixie Belle, and it gave the piece another layer of depth. I wanted it to show the pretty details that it has, and I didn't go extremely crazy with it or too bold or gaudy, but it just gives it that extra oomph that it needed. And here we go. This is without filters on a hazy day in Dallas, but look how beautiful it ended up. I'm super happy with it. The gold shines beautifully. All of the layers of paints, the different colors, the waxes, it all just came together, and it makes it look fantastic. This buffet is very large. It is about 80 inches wide and 38 inches tall. So it is a huge statement piece, and it lives in my foyer. I absolutely love it. It came out exactly how I had a picture in my head for a long time. It looks fantastic. What do you guys think? Please leave me your comments and let me know what you think. And please subscribe to the channel. I am trying to grow it every single day. Leave me any suggestions on what you would like me to do and what you would like to see. I can do every type of different painting technique. So I'd love to know what you guys would like to see. And again, thank you all so much for watching. I really enjoyed doing this video, and I hope that you like watching it and seeing the end results. I appreciate y'all. Also, go and subscribe to my Instagram, because I do daily updates on there and daily stories. Thanks so much, y'all. Bye.